This is Duke University.
Hi, my name is Greg Goswell, and I'm a fifth-year PhD candidate in the Department of Chemistry at Duke University. We have a new paper that just came out in ACS Applied Materials and Interfaces that's about a mechanochemically active soft robot. A mechanochemically active soft robot is a robot that does change shape and does move and walk and grab and sort of undulate and move around. What we've done is introduce chemistry to it by taking advantage of the forces, the stresses and strains that are already in the network to introduce sort of new opportunities for chemistry. So in addition to changing color, you could also imagine releasing small molecules sort of wherever a deformation or a stretch was greatest. This would include just different payloads. You could have something that you would want to interact with the environment, such as an antibiotic or some form of drug, some other molecules that might help with self-healing and repair. Or further indications that the robot is experiencing damage and wants then to heal itself in chemistry that exists where it needs to be to actually make that happen. So now I'm going to show you the actual material that we make the robot out of and the color change you can get by stretching it. It's just a strip here and you can stretch it and I'll show you exactly the color change that you would get in the robot. So what's different about our soft robot is the ability to see where stress is in the network. And we've introduced a molecule that reports when it's experienced some amount of force and it turns purple. So that color change is useful for us because we can design other molecules to put in its place to introduce new functionality to the robot. The robot works by inflating it with air to get the motions that you want. We've recorded several videos where we can actually show you the function of the robot as it is inflated with air and can grab something or can walk around. And you can pick up the material, but also you get that color change associated with it. And with that color change, you can see where the molecule is experiencing that deformation or that force, that stress.
Produced by Duke University.